On today's show, we look at the latest and how you can manage changes coming to Office 365. We'll take a look at how changes are rolled out in the service, how you can be the first to experience changes within your Office 365 tenant using first release, and extend that access to just select people. We'll also show you how you can stay up to date with updated resources, even on the go. Joined today by Arpan Shah. So this is a familiar topic with admins, but how do you and your team really manage change in the cloud?
So as we move from on-premises to cloud, what used to be multi-year upgrade projects are now continuous updates. So this basically gives admins and users the most modern experience, but also means changing the way you manage the service.
This is a lot to digest for an admin when you think about how change management typically works in IT. There, we've had Julia White on the show just a few weeks back where we actually showed 365 plus innovations in the last year. How does that work and how do I really consume that as an IT admin?
So the way it works is we have engineering teams who develop features, and let's say you have thousands of engineers developing features for 365. They build them and test them amongst themselves. That's kind of the first internal ring of testing. And then once that passes certain criteria, it moves to the whole office team, which is thousands of people. And then we roll it out to all of Microsoft, which is 100 plus thousands of people. And once we feel good about that, and once we get a lot of feedback and we're ready to go, we release it externally to a first release ring. And that's basically people opt in and say, hey, I want the features first. And the benefit there is Microsoft can get feedback, and they're able to test the features, see them first, build training, and so on and so forth. And then once we feel good about that, we roll it out worldwide.
So when that happens, though, does everybody get the change at the same time?
Not exactly. So because we have such a global footprint, I mean, we're around the world, you have a lot of servers, you have a lot of data centers, so we start rolling out the features, and some features can take just a few weeks for it to get rolled out globally. Some features can take longer. But the nice thing is that every single customer has a benefit of saying, hey, I want to be part of first release. It's a feature in the tenant. So let me show you how that works.
Okay.
So here I'm in the admin center, and I've actually chosen the updates option on left-hand side. And you can see over here that we have a couple options. First is standard, which is basically you're in the worldwide ring. You're like, hey, I'll get it whenever everyone else gets it.
Right.
But we also give the option to get into first release in two ways. One is your entire org. So let's say you're a small company and you're all kind of want to be on the edge of cutting technology. You can say, give it to everyone. But okay. What we find a lot of customers doing, mid-size, large customers, is they choose the second option, which is brand new. We announced this at Ignite, where you can choose select people who have access to the first features. So in this case, I'll search for everyone that starts with an A, and Ann Wallace is someone in my IT staff, and she might be part of change management group, she might be part of a PMO, and now she can get the features first, test them out, give feedback to Microsoft, and also start building some training that she can roll out to end users.
So taking a step back, what that means when I set the organizational setting, my entire organization, all of the people in my tenant will actually move into that first release ring. But now this new capability allows just a few people, the select people, maybe the IT team, maybe a couple of initial testers that are really tech enthusiasts in the org, to go into that first release ring, only those guys. That means that you don't have to set up trial or demo accounts or those types of things, or maybe pay for a test tenant when you can just have those few select people into that ring.
Now, this doesn't work for SharePoint, Skype, for Business, and Yammer yet, but you know we'll keep improving that feature.
We've done a lot in terms of also communicating the changes that are coming or upcoming. So why don't you show us some of the new things that we've done there as well to really make sure that people get a heads up for what's changing.
Yeah, absolutely. So over a year ago, we released, and Jeremy, you remember, like our team released the Office 365 roadmap.
Right.
So a lot of people were saying, hey, we want to know what you're shipping. We want to understand so we can start planning. So we listened to that feedback, and now anyone can actually go to this public website, which hangs off of success.office.com, and you can see what's launched, which are features that are recently available to everyone else, features that are rolling out, like I said, because of the physics. we start rolling things out, mm-hmm. and that can take a few weeks. So these are features that are rolling out right now in the service. And just to give you an example, this is a really nice responsive UI. We give you information here, like the notification pane,
yep.
that's rolling out right now. And as these features roll out, we actually go ahead and share more and more information on the roadmap, and we blog about it on okay. on our blog. And you can see some other categories here in development, which are features that we're currently in the kitchen that engineering is building, but we want to give people a heads up, and then canceled. We don't like to put things there, but we want to be very transparent. So if there is something that we said we're doing, and then we're postponing it or changing it,
right.
That's our way to do that. We received really positive feedback, but people said that this was overwhelming, that there was a lot of changes.
Right.
So we added a new feature here, which allows you to choose only to show recently updated features. So if you're someone who looks at the roadmap every couple weeks, you may not want to see the whole laundry list. So you can choose that option and get a trimmed down version of it.
I know we've also done a lot of work in terms of the message center and really targeting information down to admins who need to know immediately about things happening in their tenant.
So the message center is a feature that we built, again, about a year and a half ago. And the idea here was to have a direct communication line with admins. We want to make sure we were able to target communication to admins based on information that they need. So it's very tenant specific, mm-hmm. which is really important. So over here, you can see the message center. And you can also see that we have categories here because we want to make it very easy for people to digest the information. So in this view, I'm seeing all the messages that we've communicated. But we also have these other categories, like prevent or fix issues, which is sent pretty much automatically. So Office 365, if it notices that there's an issue mm-hmm. in a configuration or something that's pertaining to you, think of an MX record change that you may need for mail flow.
Right.
We would target it for you. Now, that's very rare.
Yeah.
So there's nothing here, which is a good thing. Then we have a category which is all about planning for change. Again, targeted, but here we're letting you things that are going to happen so you can plan for it.
Okay.
So this is a really good example here. We're planning to make some changes to SharePoint. And this may change your business workflow. This may change the way your end users expect something to happen.
Right.
And we want to give sufficient time, information, so you can plan for this. And the last category is stay informed. And stay informed is information that is relevant if you want to learn more about what's coming. It's more informative, again, targeted.
Mm-hmm.
But things like new features. So for example, we just released Office for Android earlier this week. The week
right.
we're shooting,
yep.
and we're letting admins know about it.
So we've also done a lot of great things in terms of making sure that you can get to this information as easily as possible on the go. So why
That's
don't
right.
you give us a peek at the actual admin app for Office 365?
Yeah, absolutely. So Office 365 admin app is available on Windows Phone, iOS, and Android. And what it does is it gives you access to information and actions on the go. So really, really cool, really, really easy based on feedback that we've got from all of you.
Mm-hmm.
So in this particular case, you can see that I have my Contoso tenant, the same thing I was looking at earlier. I can go ahead and manage users. So I can pick a user. Let's say I pick Ann again, who was part of first release.
Yep.
I can reset her password, super, super easy, because you can imagine users forget their passwords. It happens. Now, on my phone, I can actually go ahead and do it. I can also assign licenses. So if I want to give her access mm-hmm. to OneDrive for Business, for example, I could go ahead and do that.
Okay.
But let's go back to Message Center or Messages. And with the new admin app, we've updated it so you also can see all the messages we just saw in the Message Center web experience.
Right.
So there's that Office for Android message right here. So I can read it on the go. And we also have some color coding or categorization based on actions that you may have to do.
Okay.
So in the web browser, I didn't point it out earlier, but there was an exclamation point. Those are the ones that were really important, things that you should look at so you can plan for it. Here, they're just color-coded in this UI.
Okay.
And the last thing, while we're not specifically talking about this today, I also want to show that we also give service health information, because managing change is not just about features we roll out, but they're also about the things that are unexpected.
Right.
So we had this functionality before. We've made it a lot better, a lot cleaner. And we've also given the option to sign up for push alerts. So if there's an issue in the service, you'll get a push notification. And as an admin, that's really important for you to know. So again, a bunch of this was built based on your feedback.
So this is all great for staying ahead of change, but the other part of managing change is really getting that information out as an admin to your end users. So we're doing a lot there. I think you mentioned Success Center earlier. Why don't you show us what that is?
Yeah, absolutely. So this is the Office 365 Success Center at success.office.com. And this is the one place for everything you need to deploy and use Office 365. So things like the roadmap are hang right off of here. But what I wanted to show you was all the kind of content and assets based on best practices that we actually post here that I highly encourage everyone to go ahead and take a look at. So if I go to the scenarios, we have scenarios that, again, based on feedback, based on customer real world examples, we actually share resources that you can go use. So things like announcement template, very, very useful.
Right.
So if there's a new feature, if there's something you want to go announce, we actually share how to go do that. We also have flyer templates. So some IT pros like to post flyers
print
in the hallway.
Posters, those types of things, yeah.
Yeah, old school.
Yep.
So we also have that. And just some great, great resources, because at the end of the day, we can ship 300 features, but success for us is for users to use this. And we want to make sure all of you are super successful, not just managing change, but driving adoption.
Right, so this is really good in terms of being able to communicate change and make it as easy as possible from an IT admin perspective. Hopefully this helps clarify how we manage change, how we communicate change in the Office 365 service, but do you have any closing recommendations?
Yeah, absolutely. So number one, sign up for first release. Just go to your admin center, click on left side updates, choose first release, and try out the select users feature. The second one is download the mobile app on the mobile platform of your choice. And the last thing is go to success.office.com for all your deployment usage needs.
And of course, you can keep up with all the latest news on the Office blog and mechanics on Wednesdays and as news breaks. Thank you everybody for watching, and goodbye for now.